Right, what's up, everybody? This is day 200 making Songbringer. 200 freaking days of development so far. This is looking like it's going to be about a two-year project, 2.5 years. And, you know, it's getting close to, by the end of this year, like in December or whatever, it'll be about a year so far. So, yeah, man, oh man, let me check this out. It's been some sweet stuff since yesterday. I fixed all those color things I was doing yesterday. So I can shift the hue a little bit for the for the trees, the plants, the lily pads, everything. What's up, Azimris? 200. Yeah, so these, I'm showing off a little bit of, there's now some grass too. There's these little grass clumps and stuff like that. So these colors are being shifted a little bit. So all these plants here, the color, they're shifted by the color of the area they're in. So if I go to like, in here, you can see that these plants are shifted a little bit towards purple. You can see it especially here in this little bush right here. So everything here is now looking good. I'm really loving these new entrances and stuff. Yeah. 200! It's amazing. It's amazing. So yeah, so today's task is to take this screen right here that I'm about to run. This area looks really boring, right? There's nothing here. Whoops. That just makes it more interesting. But anyways, this goes up to an entrance right here. So I want to turn this into a grand staircase. So right here, there'll be some stairs. And they'll come all the way down to about the middle of the screen here. Maybe on each side, I'll do some sort of like gargoyle statue or something like that. And then just cliff walls, cliffs, rocks full of just cliffs all on the sides here to make this just grand entrance into this level. And I'll be able to do that in multiple different areas and change up the style that it's using for these grand staircases. But this will give some real feeling of height or Z or, you know, just depth to the whole world. Because right now you run around and it kind of feels like you're in a world that's entirely flat. And it's not meant to feel that way. Even though it does have some 3D going on and like these little dips right here, and like if I walk into that dip, it'll be, you know, it'll go up and down, but it'll be a lot more. Yeah, thanks, man. What's up, Jonah19? What up, you guys? Thanks, man. Thank you. Feels good to be, you know, I've always been the kind of guy that finishes what I start, so. You know, I never, ever... Yo, what's up, Wolski? Shifu. What's up, Wolski? Hey, it's art day today, Wolski. I bet you're stoked. So first thing I want to do is go into this screen. I'm going to create this grand staircase, right? That goes from this level to this level. And the first thing I'm going to do is go turn off the blend shader so it doesn't do the whole nice effect on the sides of the screen. So then I can take a screenshot of that and then do some mock-up art. Yeah, the grassy bits are looking good too, right? I'm gonna eventually do some really tall trees too that I think will really help make the whole overworld look really more interesting too. But for now, I really want to do this art for these stairs. What's up, Coin54? So yeah, start with turning off this shader. Take a screenshot, and then I'll work straight off that screenshot to create some sort of mock-up stairs, and then I'll break that mock-up into some tiles that I can put into the world. Okay, so yeah, here's what the world looks like without any shader applied. Oh, and I actually want to run this in tiny screen mode. Oh, well, this you'll understand. It's art day today. Woo! You can turn your brain off. At least I can turn my brain off. Or half my brain or whatever. Oh, yeah, I want to run this in window size tiny. That'll give me the lowest resolution possible. So I can actually work on the pixels instead of... So, and then I can just take a screenshot. Let's scare this bird away, though. There we go. Cool. I press the P key to take a screenshot. Go back to the other window size. We can use this one's fine. Actually, maybe the one where he's looking to the right. Oh, he doesn't have that. Never mind. Yeah, cool. Here we go. This will work. I'll use this to create a mock-up. Okay, and then I'm going to go and turn back on the shader just so I don't forget. Okay. All right, so I'm going to switch into art mode. Grab out the graphics tablet. Okay, so the first thing I want to see is some grand stairs. Let's get what this world would look like without this tree here. How many shaders? I really use three shaders primarily. Where are they at? There's a shader for the blend, for overall blend. Actually, there's four shaders I use primarily. There's the blend shader, which blends like big old shades. There's the blend fast shader. There's the blur shader. Oh, there's the cube wave shader. Okay, I used to use all these, never mind. The psychedelic shader, the reflection shader, the ripple shader, sphere shader. All these I use, but primarily I use the blending shaders mostly, and the blur shader for the shadows, and the reflection shader for all the reflections. Yeah, in total I put a lot of time and energy into these shaders, so really proud of those. So yeah, that's about how big and wide that path will be. There's a shader that shades shaders. Is there? Well, I don't want it. I got enough shaders already. Trying to think of what color I'll use for these stairs. And this is kind of an interesting color to work with right here. This is sort of brownish, but grayish. Yeah, I think I'll start with that. Oh yeah, what did I do about hue variance? Oh, such a good question. Yeah, so after I tried all that, I was thinking about, oh, what I'm going to do. And I downloaded that shader for that was recommended on Unity's forum about palette swapping. And I was looking into all that. And then I thought about how I'd do my own shader to do like a hue shifting and shift more towards blue when it's darker and shift more towards yellow when it's lighter. And then... I tried this out. I just randomly tried out in the game. I went and said, you know what? What if I just tinted it anyway? So I left all of the trees with their regular color and shading and everything. And then I went and actually just tinted it slightly. So you can see that when I apply colors to the plants, like here is the color applied to the plants. It looks like that. It's really bright, right? So that just barely shifts the color of the plants. And in fact, if I went more saturated, it would see it even more more colored. But because I've desaturated it so much, it just barely shifts the color. And so let me show you what that looks like in the game. Oh, it's in God mode already. Thanks, man. What's up, novice? Yeah, so I'll show you how it looks with and without that tinting. Or actually, I'll show you some areas that really have the most tinting going on. So instead of writing any kind of hue shader at all, I didn't even use it. I simply just kept the colors as they were and then just barely shifted them a little bit. So here's a good example. You can see that this bush right here actually has a highlight which is a little whiter, a little more less saturated, but applying a tiny bit of color to this just barely shades it to the plant color for this area. And then if I go to you can see it all also in the yellow of these trees right here. The yellow of these trees used to be a little more yellow, but because it's shading that tiny bit of green, it makes them a little bit more green. And then also when I go to these, where's the dark forest? The dark forest, you can really see it because that's probably the biggest shift you'll see. See, look at the plants, right, the bushes right here. These are a lot more purple because the color I'm shifting the plants to is sort of purpley or bluish. So it really doesn't shift that much, but it shifts enough to make the plants look like they really fit inside this area. So it's good enough. And it's the least complicated of all the solutions there was, so I ended up loving it and just stuck with it. Nice, right on. Okay, I'm gonna start a new layer and draw the stairs first. Actually, it might be good to do the stairs out of this color, but a little lighter, maybe that color. Yeah, actually I'm gonna use the rock colors to do these stairs because these will be hewn out of rock. Yeah. How's it going, man? It's going great. And no, I'm not tired. I'm feeling great today. I think that's about how big the stairs will be. You can see this is kind of off center. That's kind of bugging me, actually. Nice. You can. So if I shift this over about 12 pixels, that's right. I woke up today. That enough. That was enough. Dude. Ah, there we go. There. So that should center these stairs. That'll make me feel better as I do this. I want these stairs to be centered. Sometimes you want to use symmetry, sometimes you really don't want to use symmetry. But in this case, I really do want some symmetry. Yeah, okay. I'm just gonna block out a rectangular region where these stairs will fit in. Something like about like that. I'll start with this color. So each stair, if you look at like the character's height, his knee's about there. I guess a stair is more like half a knee. So maybe like 3 pixels per stair, maybe 4. Yeah, let's keep it 3. So each stair is going to have a highlight, some shadow. This is a good character color to go for. Oh yeah, we're already using that color there. Okay, let's use this highlight. What happened? Sample that color. Dude. Once again, my computer's going crazy. I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some ice. Computer loves ice. It's an ice whore. Mac laptops, you gotta love them, but man, in the summertime, they overheat like crazy. Especially with Photoshop, man, just drawing some pixels. Photoshop eats up the CPU. CPU. PU. Yes, yes, it is possible to be a beggar. Sorry about that, Galactic Knight. There's no bot or anything on here. I've tried some bots, but they never turn out to be... I don't know. Just never kept them for some reason. Yeah, Wolfsky, if you just pre-order the game, you instantly become an honorary backer. So all you got to do is... Basically, you're getting the game cheaper than it's probably going to be coming out. It's like I'm thinking the game actually might be like $20 or $19.99 or something like that on Steam when it's first released. So getting if you pre-order the game, you get the game cheaper than when it comes out. You get the original soundtrack as well, and you get honorary backer status, so your name gets in the credits. So your name will actually appear part as all the names that are shown on the main menu. So you'll be seen right here. So these are backers from the actual Kickstarter and some of the backers from pre-ordering, the honorary backers. So by pre-ordering the game, you get your name right there. And you're also going to get your name in the actual credits of the game when the credits are rolling at some point. But this just like randomly selects backers and shows their name. And if you back at the $64 level and above, your name gets in gold too. Special thanks to Wolski. Yes, you can put whatever name you want, and you can put, yeah, totally. Yeah, so if you really want, I can even make it so your name says special thanks to Wolski. That's easy. Okay, yeah, let's get back into drawing this. What? Why doesn't it sample the color? Sample. The color. What? Oh, the whole time I had a little bit of something selected down there. That's why I was doing it. Yeah. Okay, so the first thing I'm doing is I'm going to paste on, I'm going to draw one layer of stairs, see how it looks. And then I'm just going to duplicate the layer of stairs all up there so I can see how they look and see if they're the right height. So before I go and detail this out, I'm going to see if it's the right height, basically. So whether it should be 3 or 4 or 5 pixels. Okay, I'm gonna try one more layer with 4 pixels in between them to see if maybe that would look a little better. I think from this perspective, 3 is gonna be more accurate, but we'll see if 4 just feels better for some reason. It looks like a glitch in the game. Cool. Yep, all art starts out really raw. All art always starts out really, really raw. Look at any kind of painting, and it starts out looking like crap. And then it all starts coming together more and more and more. What's up, Teak? What's up, Pyrule Spy? Yeah, it's day 200, right? It's crazy to see how far this game's come in 200 days. Yes, yeah, I played your game. Yeah, I mentioned that the other day. I did. You have a certain question or something? No, I haven't. What's that? Should I look it up right now, or you want to tell me about it? Yeah, Wilski, I just did that. Did that a second ago, and I measured that it should be about 3 pixels, and I tried that the first row, right? I tried 3 pixels, 3 pixels, 3 pixels. Now I'm trying 4 pixels, because I know 4 pixels is not as accurate, but it might feel better. So I'm trying out this strategy of trying things that are not as brain accurate, but... This is less logical, but maybe it would look better. We'll see. Yeah. All right. Is the game going to focus a lot on story? Not a lot, but it will have a story. the main focuses of this game is supposed to be a lot like Zelda 1, and Zelda 1 didn't really have much of plot, but there is going to be plot, and there's going to be story from your, there's a lot of interaction between you and Jib, there's other characters, there's NPCs, and there's an overarching plot outline, which I've already written. So there'll be dialogue, there'll be, like, you'll be see, like, some dialogue appear above his head, and there'll be dialogue appearing above Jib's head, though Jib's dialogue you'll never understand as a player. But you'll only understand through Rock saying something to reply to him. But yeah, I'll be working on that pretty soon, actually, because I want to get the first version of dialogue started so I can, because I want at least a little bit of it to be part of the new alpha version coming out soon. But what about the part where the foot lands, like the lighter color one? What you mean? Trollinsky, is Xcode harder than Unity 3D? Depends. Depends on what you want to do with it. Xcode, usually you're coding more of the stuff, so in essence, yeah. If you don't know how to code, then Unity is going to be a little easier. So see what I mean? When I go from 3 pixels to 4... I might do 3 and then occasionally a 4th one. Yeah, well, I'm still working on it. Yeah, true, right? So when I go to 4 pixels, it does look a bit big, right? When I go back to 3 pixels, it does seem to fit better. Let's put the player right next to it to see. Or put any kind of hero right next to it. Yeah. Yeah, that's definitely going to be too big. Almost this 3 pixel one almost looks too big. Yeah, those are going to be too big for sure. Actually, that makes me want to try 2 pixels. Let me try that. First thing in art is always to dial in proportions, because I can go in detail out each one of these stairs and make it look totally sick, but then if it's the wrong proportion, I've just wasted a lot of time. So that's why I'm doing this first. Yeah, see, now it's starting to look more like a garage door or something else. So this might, that's too tight. Three is the pretty much the max. Four is getting too big. Okay, so it is. Three it is. Awesome. Got that figured out. Now I can just make these look better. Start with this edge. This brighter edge right here really should never, shouldn't be like that very often. Yeah, totally right. Good guess. 3 pixels. So this highlight's looking a little too bright to me, so I'm gonna go with the more toned down highlight. Ah, what did I do? Does anyone know what the heck I just did there? I did this one time before, and I have no idea how to get rid of this thing now. It's gonna be here forever now. There some view like don't show that. Don't show extras. Okay, it's an extra. Whatever it is, it's an extra. This is the kind of texture that would be really easy to procedurally generate. When I first started this game out, I actually wanted to make every texture in the whole game procedurally generated. What's up, PETA? Welcome to the stream, Alessandro. Making some stairs, a grand staircase entrance to a level. Which graphic tablet? I have the Bamboo. It's a Wacom Bamboo. And there's like lots of them kind of like this one. It's very simple, you know, graphics tablet. There's lots of them like this now. They're around $75. So they're really reasonably priced. And I think they're essential. It's an essential tool to have as a game developer. Even if you're just a programmer, I highly recommend getting one, because then you're going to be more likely to use it. I bought one and then it just sat on my desk for about a year before I ever used it. But man, now it's like indispensable. Huh? What? What are you saying? Okay, this is good enough for now to just, so now I can let's put some cliffs around the edges of this and then put some sort of like gargoyle type like statue or something like that in front of it. So I've got some cliff art already. I don't know where it is though. Oh, I just looked there. Cliff, maybe that's it. No, that's a really, really old mock-up. Cliffs, where would I have put that? Yeah, moss and weeds, totally. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do those kind of touches after I get at least these. I wanted the whole image to start to really pop by adding some more depth with these sides, cliffs, and some kind of gargoyle or gargoyle crachu. Yeah, that'd be cool. A gargoyle on top of a crachu, so that like the gargoyle is the thing that comes alive. Hold on a sec, I gotta get some ice, man. This is so cool. It's so hot today. What's up, Nano? I'm working on this scene where you'll have some stairs that lead up to another level. So, stairs. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It might be called like mountain cliffs or something. Look at that old one. All right. It must be in common. Or maybe it's unused. Cliffs, here we go. There. Hey, what's up, Sumus? Welcome to the stream, man. I'm doing good. Really great. Just making some art today for a level entrance. For like a stairs, actually. Stairs that lead up to a level entrance. How are you doing, man? Oh, man. Damn. Nice. Whoa, that's sweet, dude. You entered your game into a competition and won. Oh, man. Good for you for winning. Sorry you can't attend it. Oh, yeah. Right on. Well, hopefully that works out for you. Yes, oh, of course, please. Yeah. Share your link. Please, I'd love to see some screenshots, a link to your game, the name of your game. Share it all, please. Nice, right on. That's a good sign, man, if you only made a prototype and they want you there. Nice. Can you post a link? Oh, what's up, Toby? Cool, man. Yeah, I'm trying to do a lot more Europe-friendly streams. I think I got started by 3 today, or 2:30 or something. Nice, man. I'd love to see a link. All right, Teak, right on, man. Good luck, good luck. All right, man. So this hue brightness is about 48, 35. What's up, Moosaurus? Welcome to the stream, man. What's up, Grizz? Thanks, man. Cheers. Yeah, I really appreciate you saying that because I'm a totally new artist. I've only been making art for a couple years, so. And I also am primarily a programmer. So I've been a programmer for a lot of years, and I never really thought I would be an artist. And today I feel like I can call myself that. So it's cool to be progressing and learning and growing in life. Something like this. All right, cool. Let's get some statues and some moss. More green would really, really help. Yeah, let's do some vines, some moss and vines. And then we'll do these some statues standing right out front. Huh? Oh. Yeah. Oh, is it 3D? Oh, you mean break out like you're breaking out of a prison? Oh, I thought you were talking about breakout like the ball bouncing game. Oh, okay, so this is like a sneaky subterfuge type game. That's cool. I like this a lot better than what I was thinking of Arkanoid slash breakout slash Pong, but this is way cooler. That's cool, man. For a simple demo, you got a lot done. This is great. Right on, man. Good job. Oh, yeah. All right. Nice. Right on. Oh, yeah. Cool, man. Good job. You must be doing something right. Yeah. Yeah, they're supposed to be vines. So somehow I can make them look better. Should probably add a little bit of shadow. Yeah, I did make them green, and then I didn't really like them as green, but I'll try them a little more green next. Yeah, okay. Cool. Good thought, you guys. I'll try a little more greenish color. I want to find a way to give him more depth. But I think I'll save it for after the gargoyles. What if I did this? There you go. There you go. That's a cool idea. Vines coming alive. Well, there you go. That's a great idea. Yeah. Leaves. Some of these vines are going to have leaves, right? Lips, lips. So a little gradient on top of this to make these look. A little deeper. Yeah, just like that. Oh, that slight little bit adds so much. Cool. Wonder what the rocks would look like with this same kind of gradient. Oh, yeah, that works. Highlights always make all the difference. Just tiny bits of highlights, though. Oh, nice. Cool, thanks, T. Nice. Cheers, you guys. Is this just a screenshot? No, it's a mock-up. Let me if you want to see the actual game, the game is a lot different than this. So this is called Songbringer. I'm in God mode right now, so my character can run around really, really fast. But so I can kind of show you a lot of the overworld. But like, it's a Zelda-like game. You have your sword. You have lots of items. This is the fire sword item I'm showing off right here. Yeah, so basically I'm working on a staircase for entering into levels that are a little bit up higher. So I want the feeling of more depth. Right now, as you run around this overworld, you get the feeling that everything is almost on the same level, right? Like this whole thing is at the same Z level. So I want to give it the feeling of depth or height. And to do that, I'm going to add these stairs. So I'm drawing stairs. These are going to be outside of a level entrance. So as you go up these stairs, you go to another level. And on this side, there'll be like a huge gargoyle statue. On that side, same thing. It'll just look sweet to be going up into a level after this. Thanks, Santa Goat. I'm gonna try that with a little bit more like white type streams and stuff. Yeah, that's the point, right? That's the goal. For now, I'm gonna keep it simple though, because as you can see, the world map that's generated, right? This world is generated from this world seed, right? Dingle is the world seed. And the area we're looking at right now sits right here, and it's going up to this level. So as you can see from that, I'm only doing these cliff entrances on areas where there's a dead end. So I'm starting that way, right? Eventually, I do want to have it so the cliff extends and there's like multiple different screens with the clips. But for now, I'm just keeping it really simple for the first day I'm trying this. And I'm just putting it on screens where there's a dead end to the north of it, right? And this is one of the, that's one. It could also put one here, right? Because there's a dead end to the north. So yeah, for now, I'm just going to do a single screen. Eventually, it'll be multiple screens. And actually, to implement multiple screens, I'm probably going to have to add some height to this entire map. So every one of these screens will have like a Z height or just a height variable that indicates how high this actual screen is compared to like sea level or whatever, or the home screen or whatever. So this would be 0, 0, 0, 0, and then this one would be 1. And as you climb into these mountains, this browner areas, these would all kind of be 1. And then some of these higher mountains would be 2, 3. So I'm thinking that's how it'll eventually work. It's kind of working, I guess. What's up, Art Games and Skittle Fiddler? Yo! Welcome to the stream today, guys. I'm working on some stairs today. This is for a screen that's going to go right below an entrance. So you'll come to this screen, and then you walk up these stairs, and that goes to a level entrance. So what I'm doing is I'm drawing this all on a mock-up image, and then I'm going to separate all this out into tiles. So like this will be like a row of tiles, that'll be a row of tiles, 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 tiles. And then that all I can randomly arrange this kind of stuff into a... Thanks, PETA. Cheers, man. Okay, I'm bored of working on the vines. I want to work on these gargoyle statues out front. In fact, they could probably sit on top of these. I don't have a solid figure. I'm not exactly sure. I know it's going to be more on the PC, at least. It's going to be more than $16. It's probably going to be $20 on PC. I was originally intending on $16, but I think I probably should make it 20 because this is like an endlessly replayable game. So, and then on iOS, it's probably going to have to be cheaper because people are so fickle on iOS and everybody wants cheap games, free games on iOS. So it'll probably have to be less there. Yo, voice of Grog. What's up, man? Hey, it's been a minute since I've seen you on here. Voice of Grog, dude. How you been, man? Nice, right on. What's up, Boogie? Nice, right on. Well, you can pre-order it right now if you want. If I was just saying this earlier, but if you pre-order the game, you get your name in the credits on the main menu. So if you pre-order it now, as I'm saying, like you get so if you actually buy the game on Steam when it comes out, you're not going to get your name in the credits, but basically, if you pre-order now, you become an honorary backer. It's as if you back the game on the Kickstarter. So you get all the same benefits that the people on the Kickstarter got when they ordered at the $16 level. So if you want to do that, it's just songbringer.com/pre-order. And that's with Humble Bundle. Oh, where the hell did the Humble Bundle widgets go? There's supposed to be Humble widgets all on this page. Oh, there they are. Okay, they're there. No need to freak out. They're there, Nat. All right. So I'm gonna make a big, tall gargoyle statue. Wait, what's up, Grim Gary? Yeah, I'm thinking these are going to be extra tall like this. Maybe extra wide too. Yeah, it's gonna be so after this game comes out in January, it's gonna come out on lots of other platforms. So if I can get if the game succeeds and it does well on Steam, then I'll have the funds to be able to put it on Xbox One and PlayStation 4. So they're kind of iffy, but for sure the game's coming out on Windows, Mac, Linux in January to March, somewhere in there, and then it's coming out on iOS, and then later on in the year, it's definitely coming out on Retro VGS as well. if the retro VGS Kickstarter as well, and that system comes out. And then after that, it'll be Xbox One and PlayStation 4 and maybe Android as well. All those are maybes, those three. But we'll see. So it's probably going to be a whole year of just porting this game. Thanks, Pity Flip. Welcome to stream. PMC, what's up? So I'm working on some gargoyle statues now that are going to go on this like level entrance type screen. It'll eventually look better than this. These cliffs don't look that great yet, and the vines are still need work and everything. But yeah, so I'm still working on this whole mock-up for it. But it'll go on this screen right here. Let me turn off God mode really quick. We can just leave God mode on. Yeah, so it'll be this screen right here that has it, right? And you walk up the stairs, and it goes to this level entrance. So it'll be like a grand entrance to this level. And then I imagine this level entrance will look a lot different too. Like it'll be all custom and stuff. So that's the goal for today. Oh, I just noticed as you get to the very top of the world, it becomes gray. All these, yeah, wow. Because it blends it with itself or something. All right, so let's move Vel. Let's draw this gargoyle. Yeah, this is meant to be like a mountain, so yeah. So I might even do some cool like background sky or something like that in that area. What are the pixel sizes for my game? That's like totally... What do you mean? What's the size of one pixel? It depends on my screen res. This adapts to whatever screen res you're on. So like this screen I'm on right now is 2560 by 1800 and it scales up. But what exactly are you asking there? So I'm going to start with an outline for this gargoyle. Just to kind of get a shape. Oh, yeah, yeah, I'm drawing in real pixels. Yeah, the size I use for Photoshop art is like about 400 by 200. See? So it's a lot like Zelda. Zelda had a height of 256. So that's kind of how I did my math, right? I started with the size of about Zelda's pixels, and then I made it widescreen. So that's how I got that size. And it works well, except on iPad. iPad, it looks horrible. So I probably have to do something else for iPad. Oh, I was hearing about this morning on Twitter, but I never really researched it. Gaming.youtube.com, huh? So, once again, Google is trying to do their own social network. They're trying to copy another social network. I wonder how well this will actually turn out. This is going to be the Google Plus of Twitching. Or is it going to be good? What's the difference? Have you explored it much? Is there a difference between this and Twitch, or is it exactly like Twitch, or what? What's up, Tappy? Cool. I'll have to check this out some more. Tappy, what's up, man? I'm making a screen right now where you'll go northwards and it goes upstairs to another screen. So here I'm on this screen, right? And I'm creating some stairs that'll go right here and some gargoyle statues on the sides. And then you'll go up north and that leads to a level entrance. So it kind of creates sort of like a grand entryway. Who turned on bicubic filtering? Seriously. Yeah. So I would definitely love to get any feedback because I kind of got bored with doing the vines. I really need to improve those. So as I do this, please let me know your thoughts. I kind of got bored with the vines and the background. So this is the area where I'm kind of like, these two areas, I'm kind of like iffy. I know I'm going to improve them somehow, but. Okay, so is that the right size for this gar? I think it may be a little bigger, a little taller. A little bigger. Might as well. The bigger, the more intimidating. The more wow. Yeah, that's about good. Oh yeah. Huh. All right. Well, it'll be interesting to see what they make of it. Hopefully they make a something cool. I gotta throw this back in the freezer, get some more water. God Who Can Fly. Cool name, man. Welcome to stream. Can you recommend a work standing? Yes, I can. I do it all the time. I definitely recommend it. First of all, you get to keep your spine well, how it should be, you know. And then second of all, you get to use more of your body, like your butt and stuff. Your butt is really important for your posture, your overall posture. And the more you sit down on your ass, the flatter your ass gets and the less you're using your muscles in your legs. So it's important to stand up, but it's also important if you're standing up to move around a lot, because you don't want to just stand in one place the whole day. You'll get really sore and you get, it's also not good for your blood flow to stand in one place forever like that. So you really want to move around, and I recommend wearing shoes. It helps wear shoes because a little bit of padding helps. Teague, what's the doll know? Yeah, you're welcome, man. Okay, I want to get a little inspiration. I'm still not that good of an artist yet, so I need to kind of look at reference images to draw stuff sometimes. So I'm going to get an image of a gargoyle and kind of get something in my mind for how this might look. Oh, that's cool. I like this one. Oh, what do I know? Oh. Oh, let's check it out, an alien one. Nice. Oh, as long as they don't force us, you mean? They're forcing YouTubers to use it? How are they forcing YouTubers to use this new YouTube gaming thing? What's up, Light of Thief? Yo, man. I'm working on a gargoyle. I'm working on a level entrance right now. So this is going to be like a screen where you walk north. Like you walk up these stairs and it goes to a cool level or something. Oh, it's for beginners. Right on. Click Team Fusion. I'm always looking for things to recommend to beginners because I get this question daily. It's an app? Oh, it's an app. Okay. So it's just like game engine in software. Cool. Yeah, so I really love this one up here. One of these first ones I saw is super rad. This one's great. I'm going to go ahead and even kind of like... I'm going to use this almost exactly as a reference image. But I'm going to draw my own. So... Oh, you have a reference folder? Nice. Yeah, I guess it's kind of a necessity, right? As an artist that really like use reference images. I've always thought that when I would become an artist that you had to think up everything yourself and you weren't a good artist if you use a reference image. But man, I don't think I've ever made anything really that good without looking at something else and at least kind of drawing from that. It's like, I don't know. I guess I'm not that good of an artist yet. But even some of the best artists I've ever seen, like I've seen so many artists, they're like the most amazing artists I've like ever, and they still use reference images for their stuff. They're creating their own thing, right? But they're still kind of looking at something. Or sometimes they go and they create Photoshop mock-ups of something, and then they go paint something amazing, or, you know, like they're creating a reference image. So, yeah, so I don't have any qualms using reference images still. So this guy's going to be about 37 high. Yeah. So make him 37. Hell, let's make him 40. Right? Yeah, that's a good way to put it, Lighter Thief. The world is one big reference image. Even if you're drawing from real life, you're still referencing. So true. Oh, yeah. Huh. Oh, sweet. Thanks, Tabby. Oh, okay. I see what you're doing over here on the left. Right there, you mean? Yeah, I could definitely do some highlights there. Yeah. Uh-huh. So you're a YouTube partner? Are they, so Teak, what's going on with you? Are they forcing you to like do this YouTube gaming thing or what? Yeah, I've seen that, the left one, cool. I'll definitely get in there and do some more highlights and shadows on this whole rock face. That's a great idea. Oh, and I see you added some highlights to the vine too. Awesome. Cool. I'll definitely play with that. Gracias. Gracias, mi amigo. Yeah, I saw your post there, yeah. I was trying to make this three color, but oh well. Oh, interesting. So it would look something like this. Cool, sweet. Camera shake. Ooh, nice. Very bouncy. It does look like an earthquake. Whoa, this one's super bouncy. Ah. Right on. Huh. Oh, that's what's going on? Crazy. That's one of the joys of game development is getting lost and things like that. Yeah. Try that. What's up, Momir? I'm working on a screen where you're gonna walk up the screen up these stairs to a new area. So it'll be stairs. It'll give the world some more depth. Feeling that you're climbing something, that you're going up higher. Initial screen? What you mean? I'll show you what I mean. So here, this screen I'm going to in this game is up here, kind of in the north of the world or whatever. So this is where you'll have some stairs, and you'll walk up these stairs to a level entrance, right? So that's what I'm doing. And then this will be a type of area too, so it can procedurally generate this kind of area, and then I can apply that to any type of world type or any type of screen type. Whoops. So it could be, you know, it could be mountainous, it could be this dark forest type of level entrance, it could be a lighter forest type entrance like this. So yeah. I'm really digging these dark forests. They're super creepy. Whenever I get it to them, I'm like, wow, what's in here? Oh, sweet. This is a cool level entrance. This squirrel just like, how did he get here? How did this squirrel get all the way to this dark forest? You're such a brave squirrel, squirrel. Yeah, it's supposed to kind of, yeah. Chess Knight, yeah. Yeah, totally, right? Yeah, it's getting so much more diverse, right? I even played the game last night. I'm like, man, this is so much more fun to play. It's way more, it feels really cool to explore the world now, because it's like there's so much more diversity. And that's why I want to do this kind of stuff, like this screen I'm working on here, because this will be another type of thing where you find it and you're all, whoa, what's this? What's up there? And then some of these screens, I might even make it so you can't really pass these stairs until you get a teleport or some item or something like that. Or maybe these stairs are broken and you have to fix them, or... You know, there's lots of cool stuff that we can do. Little Riding Hood in the Dark Forest. Oh. Yeah, I can totally see how you would get that vibe, right? Or Hansel and Gretel. Yeah. It feels so good to have the game coming along this well. It's great in game development when you finally make a lot of progress at once. You know, sometimes you're pounding away for a long, long time, and then finally you make these breakthroughs, right? It was kind of like that with Songbringer for a minute, because it had been a long time before the world had really gotten that much better. So it's really nice to see that happen. It's like everything happens at once, and all of a sudden it's like, whoa. Breadcrumbs? These are great ideas for the Dark Forest. Yeah, breadcrumbs, a witch hut, some bears. Candy? A candy house, right? What's up, the Lags Group? Slenderman Easter egg. What's that? Is there going to be a wizard? Yeah. I think there's got to be, have to be some kind of wizard NPC. Somebody was asking that the other day. Like, is there going to be the wizard from your old game? Maybe. I want to say maybe now so that I can surprise you later. Oh, damn. Is that like an achievement? Oh, how long did it take? How long did it take to do that? Dang, 2 months? Wow, this sounds like a really hard one. Legs are sore today. This is turning out pretty good, actually. I'm really glad I used a reference image here because I would have had no clue how to really draw this myself from creativity if I were to try and draw something from purely creative zone. I just wouldn't have had a clue how to do this, but this reference image really helped. Yes, I did. Lighter Thief, totally. So, I ended up using a really simple technique. I had explored how that one Unity form thing about how to do palette swapping, and then I tried. I actually thought about how I would write my own shader. So I would shade things sort of like closer to yellow if it was brighter, and closer to blue if it was darker. But I ended up just doing a very simple technique where I just kept the color inside the color depth inside the trees, right? As you can see from the trees, like on this screen, you can see that there's plenty of color depth, like in the trees right in here, right? You can see that one tree in its leaves has several different hues, slightly different hues, but. And then you can also see that each tree is a little bit unique, right? This one's a little bit more green. This tree's a little bit more yellow. So yeah, all I did was I kept things really simple by just barely tinting the trees. So it's just a simple tint technique, and in OpenGL, that's just setting the color of the vertices of your sprite or whatever. But anyway, so like here, for example, is the tint of the plants in the light area. See that? It's a really desaturated color and it's very bright, 100% brightness, so it just barely tints the sprites. So yeah, and that turned out to look really amazing. I'm like, because when yesterday when we were looking at it, and I was like, man, they're looking really flat. Not only was it losing the color depth, but it was also losing some of the saturation and the vibrance in the coloring. And this technique somehow works to keep the saturation and the vibrance and the color depth. So I'm like, you know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna leave it like that. So yeah, very simple technique. I didn't even have to write a shader. And but the one drawback of this technique is I can't really make these trees look red, for example. I can't really shift them that much. If I really wanted a red or a pink or a purple or a blue tree, I would have to draw some separate leaves that were actually about that color, and then tinting it a little bit would help them look a little bit more varied. So that's the only drawback, but I think that's good enough. You know, I can go and create some blue trees for a different type of world or whatever if I want. So yeah, turned out really well. I like how it turned out. Yeah, the grass is totally new. Yeah, I added the grass this morning. All the grass is just like a little entity, so they actually move. I'm only using two. Yeah, it's the same exact grass from the lake, so it's not like So I need to draw some more though. I need to draw a lot more like grass entities. So far, you can see I've only got these two types of grass, and then there's also this grass here on the lily pad, which is just kind of built into the lily pad. So I need to expand these and create like more types of grass. Taller grass, shorter grass. And I also want to make it so as you walk over the grass, it rustles the grass. And that, I think that'll really, really help the game feel better too. Yeah, thanks, Slider Thief. Okay, you know what? This is looking pretty good, actually. And a wild Pokemon will come out. Yeah. That cute monster. I am not using CC Light Node. I don't even know what that is. But if you're talking about making lights and ambient darkness, let me take a look. I don't think you're talking about shadows. You're talking about the actual lighting shader. And that was a series of videos. What were they called? I'm pretty sure it had the word shader in it. No, it wasn't the shader magic one. It wasn't the psychedelic shader. I think it was here, around here. Day 30, secret shader sauce. Photoshop-like shader. Yeah, so around day 30, you're going to see that. And let's... How do I see this? Anyways, I was trying to give it to you with the playlist so you can, like, go through it. But I think this is about it. I think that's around when I was creating lights and stuff. Ooh, that's interesting. Can wear the grass down. So how many times do you have to walk over a piece of grass until it's totally worn down to dirt? Yeah, you're welcome, man. So yeah, you'll have to explore around there and like go to the previous videos or maybe the next videos, but it's around there. And if that's not what you were thinking, then come back and I'll definitely try and help you find what you were actually looking for. Yeah. I was saying, how many times do you have to walk over a piece of dirt or piece of grass until it was worn all the way down? Like 100 times, 200 times, or does it happen really fast? Like 10 times you walk over it and there's no more grass. Oh, you know what? This is looking good enough to see this in action. Cool. This is gonna be sweet. Hell yeah! I drew a gargoyle. Oh, 50. Ooh, right. Yeah, I like that. I like how it would build up. Yeah, I know. Coco's 2D added a lot of cool stuff to it. The projects branched at one point a long ways back, like in 2011, about 2010 even. So. Ah. You're scared? It's okay, Boogie. It's okay, man. Huh, I guess it could be gold or bronze. Yeah, I mean, or I could try lightening it a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, could be. Have you looked at the Cocos 2DX extensions though? There's a lot of extensions to Cocos 2DX that people have published on GitHub. So that might already be done. Yeah, here's effect nodes. Lightning bolt, tail, ripple, break, shatter. Here you go. What's up, Overcaster? Welcome. What's up, man? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, maybe I will. I'd rather just see a video, though. Is there any videos on it? Oh, this is just bump mapping and normal mapping. Yeah, Cocos 2DX has this. Yeah, you can generate normal maps already, and there's even a tool for doing that. There's lots of tools already for generating normal maps, or you can generate a normal map with your own kind of shader, and then you just normal map it. There's a class already for that. Nice, right on, man. It's been great. Yeah, it's been great. On-demand normal map. See, this is pretty cool. I'm sure there's a class already written for that for Cocos 2DX. On-demand normal mapping would be sweet. Yeah, Momir, it's just the fan. I got a fan going because it's hella hot. See what I mean? No noise. But it's hella hot, so I gotta keep it on. Cool. Yeah, I'm saying you can make that with Cocos 2DX. And in fact, I bet you that's already in Cocos 2DX somewhere. An on-demand normal map. Yeah, thanks, Jogger Gamer. We're all fan noise. Yeah! Okay, let's experiment with making these metal. I guess I'll make a backup of them first. Ooh, see, just making them a little bit green, I can imagine some moss would be on them. Yeah, I was talking about an extension though. There's probably an extension or somebody wrote one on GitHub or something. Which character did I enjoy rendering the most? I didn't render any of the characters. You mean draw? I enjoyed drawing this main guy, Rock, the most. He's pretty cool. But actually, it was really fun to do the animation for her when she gets up and she shakes her hair. It's kind of cool. Sort of like make them a little green. I'm gonna save that one. Let's try that again with some other experiment like bronze or metal. Oh, red works as well. Thanks, Jackal Gamer. Yeah, Teak, right. Red. This is kind of looking cool with red, for sure. It might be a little scarier, too, with red. I don't know. Yeah, I like a green, too. Green's great. It's nice to have it just a little bit different than the stone. Whoa, this sort of, like, purple. That's too much. Yeah, I don't really like the purple or the blue that much, but the red kind of works too. What about, so there's super green. This sort of cyany blue also works a little bit. Let's do a red one. Yeah. Okay, I'll try it. That's a good one. I'm just gonna save a bunch of these, right? And play around with this a lot, and then I'll choose one later by just selecting a layer, right? So here's the original. Duplicate again. Let's try a red one now. It's Statue of Liberty green, right? Oh, which is bronze, which has gone and aged itself or oxidized, right? That works. So let's try red this time.
What's up, baby?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Hue, let's try. Yeah, I'll guess try this red one. Like it here. That's cool too. So we got, there's a green one. There's sort of a teal one. Here's a red one. Oh, it's so hard to choose. You know what? Maybe I'll just make them gray and then I'll color them in the game. Yeah, that's what I'll do. Okay, that's easy enough. Man, it's hard to choose. It's really hard to choose. Okay, so let me check on my time, how long I have left today's stream, and then we'll see if we got time to put this in the game. Holy crap, I've already been streaming 2.5 hours. Oh, hue shift just one of them? Yep, well, I could do that in the code as well. Animated Flash Disco. Oh, you guys are cracking me up. Okay, well, I've already streamed a hell of a long time today. So, I think I'll go another 5 minutes. We'll see how much I can get done in 5 minutes. I don't know if I'm going to be able to like put this all in the game in 5 minutes, but we'll see. Yeah. Yeah, I'll be going in a sec. Yeah, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. Okay, well, we need a pillar. We need a gargoyle. Okay, I'll start exporting these one at a time. Yeah, this is definitely going to take longer than 5 minutes, but you guys will get the drift of what I'm about to do. The link to the plugin? You mean this plugin? It's an extension. You mean why not have variations? Yeah, that's what I was just saying. I'm gonna color it gray, and then I'm gonna procedurally color it in the code in the game. So some areas will have red ones, some areas will have green ones, and some will have the teal. And yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, nice. Crazy. Cool. Watch it on the Xbox. Type it on the phone. Oh, the glory of having so many devices these days, right? So, somehow this got to be way too dark. I need to make this lighter. Yeah. Tefan, what's up, man? Yeah, sorry, I've already been streaming for about 2.5 hours. I'm really only streaming for another 5 minutes or so, but you can see kind of what got done today. This is a screen where you'll walk up these stairs and you'll go to another screen. So it's just like a grand entrance to a level. You know what I mean? You walk up these stairs and then up there, there's something really cool, like a level entrance or whatever. I still need to work on these parts, the background rocks, the cliffs, and the vines. They don't look that good yet, but I'll fix that up, make that look better. I really like these gargoyle statues though, so that will be easy to put in there first, and then I'll put in some stairs, and then I'll put in some cliffs, and this will all be sort of procedurally generatable. I'll be able to generate an area kind of like this, or change it a little bit, you know, for each screen, each type of area. Thanks, man. I need to see what the other pillars were. Nice, thanks, man. Yeah, that's actually procedurally generated texture. So I started off with ground texture color, right? I just started off with a single color, and then it generates texture. It generates some purlin noise to give these areas this depth. And you can actually walk down in it if you. Sorry, I'm in God mode right now, so it's like I'm walking so fast. But let's turn off God mode really quick, so you can get what I'm trying to say here. So like the player is at kind of like a height right here, and then as he walks into this, you can see he walks down a little bit and then walks back up. Actually, I might have disabled that. That doesn't seem to be working as well. Or maybe it's just not as deep as it used to be. But yeah, he should be going down a little bit as he gets to the bottom of this little hole here. Thanks, man. Okay, so I need a reference image for the pillars so I can get this brightness and the color to be about the same. Sprites pillar, common pillar. There it is. Screw it. I'll just redraw this. All right. I guess I'll call this pillar two. Cool. All right. One asset done. Pillar two. We go save this for the web. Prepare this thing. Need help?
No, I'm just
going to
set these images
in
for the
fucking
chat.
All right.
Thanks.
Okay, we'll put this in sheets, common, pillar two. Okay, next up, we don't need that reference image anymore. We don't need this pillar. We don't need Vel. We don't even need the map Dingle. Okay, now we need the gargoyle. We'll get the gargoyle facing east. I like this little slight adjustment. This is a good one to start with. All right, Ladder Thief, good night, man. So I'm putting this guy in the center. Yeah, that's about the center right there. So it's easier to center him on the pillar when I place him there. And now I'm gonna actually, let's put this guy in foes. Sprites, foes, gargoyle. Because I think eventually this guy will come to life as an enemy. For now, he won't. Oh yeah, so next thing, I'm gonna make him gray. So I can color him in the code. Breathe fire, yeah. Maybe that's how he comes to life. He just breathes fire. That's a cool idea. Maybe his eyes light up and he just has a fire breathing thing instead of him being some animated, awesome, rad enemy, maybe he just does some kind of projectile like fire. That's cool. I like that. I could even see any of the other elemental effects like lightning going between the two gargoyles or ice, maybe he freezes you. I don't know. Okay, so we got a gargoyle, we got that. Now we need some stairs. How am I gonna do this? Because I like how this kind of has. Yeah, I think this needs to be one big sprite. Yeah. Okay, I think this is about where I have to leave off today's stream. Seath, what's up, man? Yeah, I might need multiple layers. Well, definitely for need multiple layers for the stairs. Because I was thinking maybe I could, because some of these screens I'm going to want to be like, you know, smaller width stairs and stuff. So yeah, I need to think about how I'll do this. And I need to redraw this too. I need to really focus on this background and make this look better. So yeah. Yeah, so yeah, thanks you guys. Cheers, have a great night. If anybody's just tuning in the stream, I stream daily sometime between 2 and 4 p.m. like in the afternoon Pacific time. This game's called Songbringer. It's coming out in January to March, something like that. So Once again, thanks for all your comments. Thanks for hanging out. And we'll see you next time, tomorrow.